Yeah, for this matchup tonight for IUPUI, I'm looking at Katie Davidson, number two scorer, number five plays, number seven in rebounds. For NKU, they need to rely on Blevins and for a 3-point shot in this game. Cannot wait for this matchup. Let's get it. Like I said at the beginning, that's her game right there. Look for her to do some damage in the paint. That's going to be the Morse's advantage in this game.
I spoke with Noah Heber this week on the Ray podcast, and she said the focus for this week in practice is paint defense, because both teams combined for 124 paint points the last time they matched up. Mm-hmm. So whoever wins that part of the matchup could be the difference. Drives the lane, puts it out to McCray, but it's not the way. IUPUI is coming away with it. Get it down in the
field.
It's called on Davidson.
Yeah, Macy Blevins, she's going to be a key factor in this game. Like, their last matchup between IUPUI had 25 points in Indianapolis. Yeah, you know, IUPUI, they're one of the worst 3-point shooting teams in the Horizon League. They need to look to drive to the basket, in my opinion.
That's a big part of how they came away with it. 95.
Jesus. Sometimes she's just impossible to be stopped in the paint. I mean, that's her game. It's been her game all season.
That's part of the reason she just won her fourth freshman of the week.
Yep. Very well deserved.
Absolutely. She's definitely running now for the freshman of the year.
Yep. If she doesn't get it, I mean,
I'll be very surprised if she can. Abby Wolfman. IUPUI gets on the board at 62 MKU. Cardinal Ford goes back.
I mean, that last possession there by IUPUI, how I mentioned, three-point shots. Three-point shots aren't falling early. They need to rely on driving to the basket and getting buckets. Yeah, that's what's going
to
keep them in this game.
And
the last two possessions, they've done an excellent job driving to the basket. Dangerous in the paint, and she's been a key factor so far in this 10-4 lead for NKU.
Ooh.
Yeah,
tough shot right there.
No easy points in the paint. That's what you'd like to see on both sides. Now with the team draws the line and feels bad. Oh, there's a jump ball. I apologize. IUPUI will get the possession.
Right.
David Johnson will bring it up. Puts it over the boat to the rocks.
Wow.
By Mitchell's team, he was averaging one run, so.
Yeah, look for her to make some big shots tonight from beyond the three. She's one of the best in the horizon.
UPU pulling it up 13-6. Oh.
Man, the Jaguars, they're doing an outstanding job staying in this game by driving to the basket and not relying on threes. Yeah, what a game.
What a game changer.
Absolutely. Key factor to helping IUPUI in the paint.
Mitchell Steen gets it in the paint, and she looks for a turnaround layup. It's no good. And she gets a rebound, and she's fouled. That was one thing.
IUPUI number four, Alexa Pulsivar. That's her first.
Yep, absolutely.
We have a ball game.
She's a top 10 scorer on the horizon. She can also play defense too, like we just saw taken away by her. Like, she's an elite player for this one squad.
Also for IUPUI number 12, Keith Davidson is replacing Musabar at the line from Jaguars number 21. Will be a ball for the first 2 feet of the rest.
I mean, so far in this game, Alex, like, both these teams, they are doing an outstanding job getting into the paint. That's been the key factor so far.
Absolutely. Last time out, IUPUI at 72 points.
That's Devon Harper and Craig.
What is our three goal?
It's a little bit of a
he's had no side of the game. He's just doing a drive to come. He's three goal up there. It's the bottom of the room. Taylor Johnson missing the first. Puts up the Davidson. He gets nothing but air. Rebounded by the Evans. Into that Terry Nash and puts the pace. Ooh, goes to the rim and it's fouled.
Re-entering the ballgame for IUPUI number 4, Alexa Isabar, and number 20, Jasmine Turner for the North, number 33, Gavin Pisano. Lacey Buggins.
And Gavin Pisano takes in for the North.
Absolutely. Like, that's our game right there. We need to see more of that.
Goodbye, Ben Simpson.
As I was saying, NKU was looking for more. He was still going because he had a really high 18 points in the win against Milwaukee on 6-9 from
yep.
We're looking for her to have a big game again.
Like NKU, they've been a team all year
that can shoot. That
duo, if they can stay consistent, like the Norse, they're a dangerous squad.
And the other one, 70 people, they probably play score in the paint.
An excellent shot.
The UI tries to respond with a three down and it's not good. Mitchell Steen puts it out to Rosano in the corner. They get it into.
Great play. Cut to the basket right there.
NKU at 26-18 right now. It's looking like it's going to be another high scoring game. Just like the last matchup in Indianapolis.
Yep.
Okay, we're going to run the perimeter now. And the PI has got some more value on him. He's going to miss a set of trick. And now he's going to get the ball in the paint. Oh, we're going off the ball.
Okay, you found line number 0 for the base. That's her first and the team's second. We have a ball game for IUPUI number 13, Bobby Lewis. Replacing Stinson for the Norse.
Yep.
Number 3, Kylie Davis.
Absolutely. Like,
and number 3, I got this one.
To keep the Jaguars in this game.
We're called Katie Davidson.
Yeah, so far in this game, they are 2 out of 3.
Wow. Previous basket is under review.
She might be 6'7" Horizon League freshman of the week.
Looking like a good start for us.
Yeah, like. She's been outstanding in this game, getting to the paint, which is so consistent. Like, she's one of the best defenders that can actually get into the paint and do some damage.
On to the North, number 10, Carter McGray, for one free throw.
Let's say look at the monitor and say 0.9 to be put back on the clock. So that's what they would do. McCray will get the attempt to finish the end of the run. And that one's good as we go along with the touch. And that's a good lead. That's a double digit lead at the end of the first quarter. Lee will be right back.
Attention fans, if anything wins tonight's game, it's your lucky day. All fans in attendance will receive a coupon for a free day single or spicy chicken sandwich at the Woody's in Cold Spring on Alexandria Pike. Please see the answers at the doors as you exit. Receive your coupon. Be loud. Good morning.
You still hear me?
I don't think so.
So.
Two minutes, I'm going to need you to go over and play by play.
I just couldn't believe that last play.
All right, I heard you singing it. What's the next line? It's a love story. You absolutely crushed it. We kept in the Valentine's theme. Congratulations, you guys are going home with an in-game prize bag. Prize bag. We really appreciate you playing with us.
Yeah. CBS kept showing.
Please help the NFL. The NFL stuff they have to our team.
Yep. I mean, I just see, like, mainly a game in the paint. Like, both offenses are doing a great job driving the ball into the paint. That's been the key factor so far. And if Carter McGregg keeps this up for NKU, it could be a difference maker. Who knows? An offensive foul? I mean, so far it's been a competitive game. I mean, when you look at these stats here, they're almost identical. 8 for 18 for IUPUI and 12 for 20 for the Norse. Yep. And you know, with the three-point shooting, like I mentioned before, IUPUI, not the best three-point shooting team in the Horizon League. I mean, they're 1 for 5 so far. But NKU, they made 2 out of 3, one from Blevins and one from Hubert. Look for them to get hot later on in this game from three.
I'm funny that you mentioned it about how you feel like shooting because NKU right now is since the last time I matched up with IUPUI, I've generally had some teams that have been 26% from three.
I mean, just like how I mentioned, Alex, look for her and Blevins to get hot from three. I think that could be a big factor for this North squad.
And can you come in with the Kenny Davis? That's her second, and the team's third. You know, ball game runs line number four, Alexa Hosovar. Replacing Lewis.
No, the shooting foul there, so we're getting down. Okay, the team set it up.
Broad shot right there.
Okay, you're coming over 21 makes you level. That's her first and the team's fourth.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Man, so far, man, it's been a turnover game so far. I mean, Carter McGray, you can't have her in foul trouble. Like, she's had a great game so far, especially in the paint. Like, we're going to need that here in the second half.
By Alexa Hosovar. That's her first and the team second.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's been one of the key parts of her game is.
At the line for the North's number 11, the line official Steve.
Getting the 4-2 free throw. Knocking down this free throw.
Yeah, she's not the worst shooter, but any. She's pretty much a bonus. Anything she shoots from the perimeter. She gets points from the perimeter from her. It's not a bonus.
Yeah.
She's not a bonus. 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 7.5 left in the second quarter. And Spencer, and they get it down.
Good luck, Dave Spencer.
Yeah, what a great play right there.
Very nice move by Spencer. And he's going to look at the attack again.
Good luck, Kamari Mitchell-Steve.
I mean, with Carter McGray on the bench right now, I'm looking for Kamari Mitchell-Steen to step up here.
Oh.
Not a good pass right there.
Leah Walton gets her layup to go.
Goodbye, Leah Walton.
Doing a great job driving the basket and having the
free throw. Number 11, Kamari Mitchell Steele for two free throws.
Yeah, so far they're 6 out of 7 from the free throw line.
Get some offense going so they can cut into this lead.
Again, gotta try to drive it right
here.
They desperately need a bucket to try to cut into the Norse's lead.
Norse still scoring pretty much a lot in the second quarter. Yeah, it's not the same way.
Last couple of minutes, though, the free throw line has been the Norse's advantage, especially with Kamari Mitchell's team. Good move right there. They need more of that driving to the basket to cut into this lead, and they need to get some defensive stops right here to stop the Norse's momentum. I mean, Walton, like you mentioned, she's 4 out of 5 with 10 points.
She's been the
biggest scorer so far for this Jaguars squad.
4-2 free throws. Also for UI number 22, Cameron Blank. Places
Walton.
Absolutely. Like, I'm surprised by that, seeing that from the number 2 scorer in the Horizon League. Like, they need to give her the ball as much as possible.
Second one is off the right iron. Now you can do all with the rebound. You get it for a point of view to Davidson.
I just said it. Didn't I just say it? Like, they gotta give her the ball more if they want to try to get back into this game. Yep, absolutely. For sure.
That one's no good.
Yep. Would be a big bucket right here.
Travis by Wilson. We have a timeout on the floor.
Both. think I should go now or?
North Station to me. Turn your attention to the video where we're in KU Athletics and Buffalo Wild Wings would like to honor today's season ticket holder of the game, Bev Burge. Bev has been a longtime supporter of the NKU Norse and to show our gratitude and our thanks for having her support, we're sitting her home with a gift card courtesy of Buffalo Wild Wings. Everyone, let's give it up for Bev, our season ticket holder of the game.
I'll take it over from here, man.
I'll be back soon.
Alright. And, do you mind if I use your statue? Radio. I'm Ben Miller filling in for Alex Perez, who is going to do an interview with NKU head coach Cameron Whitaker. So I'll be taking over play by play as NKU leads 39-30 with 4:10 left in the third quarter. As here comes Kamari Mitchell's team putting up with the right hand. No good. Hey, right with the rebound. No. Blocked by the rim. Gets your rebound. What's it up? Can she do some damage into that game? That is her game, folks. Here comes Walton, putting up with the left hand off the glass and in. Here comes Kylie Davis. Mitchell Steen, into the paint, puts it up. No good. Scramble for it. Looks like that is Jones with the rebound. Jones finds. Jones is
by Katie Davidson.
That one will go. Or excuse me, that was Davidson. So here comes Kylie Davis. Out to Mitchell Steen. Hubert. Mitchell Steen. Finds Carter. McGray finds Mitchell Steen again. McGray sets a screen. Mitchell Steen puts it up, no good. McGray with the rebound, gets the
rebound.
She cannot be stopped from getting in that paint.
I can give my fellow up with 50 and welcome to the first. We have a ball game for the horse number 21, Macy Button.
Places Mark McGray, that is her
the line for the horse number 10, Carter McGray. One free throw.
She's showing everybody why she deserves to be Horizon League Freshman of the Year. Was the first attempt, and that one is no good. NKU leading 43-34 with 2:48 left remaining. As here comes Davidson for three, no good. But Walderman gets the bucket. We got a whistle. Looks like we got a timeout. MKU leading 43-36 with 2:43 left in the second. You are listening to MKU Women's Basketball on North Star Radio. Stay with us. Kylie Davis to bring it up for the Norse, who lead 43-36 with 2:36 left in this first half. Blevins gives it to Carter McGray. Can she add another one? Absolutely. With her 20th point of the contest. Good possession for IUPUI right here. Oh, intercepted by Noelle Hubert, and she is bringing the heat.
Backside of it finds Kylie Davis.
Davis, 15-footer. 47-36, NKU. And a steal by Kylie Davis. Finds Carter McGray. Oh, doesn't get that one, but Blevins with the rebound. And she is rejected. Gets her own rebound, kicks it out to Noelle Hubert. Blevins finds Carter McGray again. McGray into the paint. Does not go. So here come the Jaguars. Desperately need a bucket right here. Oh, we got a foul. Looks like on Stinson. Carter McGray. Kamari Mitchell-Steen. Sorry about that. Kamari Mitchell-Steen thought about a three. Flips it back out to. And we got a whistle on the play. Basket does not go.
Okay, you found the number 11, Kamari Mitchell-Steen. That's your second.
Second foul on Kamari Mitchell-Steen. So here comes the Jaguars. Johnson. Jaliyah Johnson. We got a three on the way from, I believe that was Lewis. Oh! Here comes Donaldson. Davidson gets it to go. Wow. Man, Jaguars, they did not give up on that play. So here comes Mitchell Steen. Mitchell Steen finds. Wow, Alyssa Lacey. Comes Johnson to bring it up for Northern Kentucky. 7 seconds left to go here in the second half. 49-38, Northern Kentucky. Here comes Johnson into the paint, puts it up off the glass. Close to the bucket there for the Jaguars. Jaguars. You are listening to MKU Women's Basketball on North Star Radio. Stay with us. Hey, man, how you doing? Pretty good. Good to see you.
Moving up, overhead with DoorDash from anywhere in the arena. Pick your favorite concessions like pretzels, hot dogs, burgers, beer, and soda, and pay no additional fees. Instead, skip the line and pick up your food and drinks as soon as they're ready. Don't have the app, look for DoorDash signs around
I'm
the
sorry.
Scan your QR code and order from
Oh, Supreme, yeah.
Fans, please welcome to the floor your Northern Kentucky University dance team.
I like it too. You know, there was rumors spreading around that Justin Bieber was going to come out with Yeah, I'm with you there.
Because I don't know if you know, but I'm really old. So, those are the people I grew up with.
Yeah. I mean, I listen to a little bit of Usher, especially his older work.
Oh, yeah. He started, like, the first three songs, like, his new stuff, and I was like, this is not a good idea. Then he sung the actual good one. So I was like, okay.
Yeah.
The commercials kind of suck. That's my opinion. Like four or five good ones, but I think that was about it.
Yeah. I was thinking when we get back on the air, I was going to share some scores all throughout college basketball. That's cool.
That sounds great.
All right.
Made in America means something.
Oh my God. It's destroying, save
30 million vehicles right here in the USA.
50-13.
That's women's basketball, but yeah.
Yeah.
The bloodline of these brothers
uncompromised. They're not as good as they used to be.
Adventurous to come, outselling everything that's
possible. I mean, I think
so much carry in the league now. Because women's basketball is all
over the heads. The best in class children.
I mean,
you think your women have one win, so.
And introduce the power of the efficient
support.
All new from the ground up.
Oh, damn, you're right.
Technology, comfort for all. Toyota's four brothers.
Yeah, they're one.
Simply rivalry at its finest. Toyota.
Are there any games in the Horizon League tonight?
Let me see. I think it's Youngstown State and Wright State. They're playing up in Dayton tonight.
So, I mean, definitely missing that one, but yeah. I'm fine with you mentioning it all. Do you have any throws to you to do that, or do you just want to go back in?
I mean, if you can throw it to me, that'd be better. Just to lead the audience into it. You still liking that journalism 440 class?
Huh?
You still liking journalism 440?
Yeah.
I mean,
not at all.
It's getting on my nerves.
Yeah.
And I'm doing good in that class, but
it's still annoying. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's way too much work.
Like mass communication. I mean, I like it better than mass communication as well, but
I'm taking them both at the same time. It's
really?
Crazy. I hate my life. Yeah.
I mean, Jankowski, she's cool, but that class, oh my God.
What's my name, Jankowski?
Huh?
for me, it's not even getting past the two.
Oh, really?
No, well, you're in 440, right?
Yeah, I'm in 440. I took,
The Soma is doing the best instrument.
Yeah, she's, 400. Yeah. She's a hard friend.
Yeah. And I don't think Jim Caskey was, but I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, the only thing I didn't like about that class was it was nothing but exams.
Yeah.
It sucked. Like, I hate classes where it's just straight up exams.
Well, usually in every other journalism class I take, and I've got to write in some little about stuff that I like.
Yeah.
Neither one has done that for me.
So who do you think is going to win it all in the women's basketball? I think it's going to be Iowa.
I'm just having a hard time believing that after the stinker they put up last year. So.
Is it going Victor?
Hey.
You know, for the conference tournaments, did you ever go up to Indianapolis or West or not?
No, I didn't yet, but I'm hoping I can this year. We'll see.
Alright.
They may not even need me or ask me to, but I'm hoping.
Yeah. Like, I'm thinking about asking Seth Cooper if I can come out and take pictures. Because I talked to Wes about that. He said, just reach out to Seth and we'll probably get you up.
I just know it's very hard to get clearance.
Yeah.
Like, do you pass it yourself? Sure, right. But I would love to go.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I've heard. He's taking a couple students up there.
So he's taking Jason, probably Nathan.
Yeah. Yeah, Carter McGray with 22.
That's insane.
Yeah. Surprisingly, freshman of the year, just give it to her already.
Yeah. Freshman of the week, they just need to name it after her.
Yeah. All right, so far she's got two fouls. Mark Mitchell Steve with two fouls. Levis with one. Davis with two.
A lot of people on the rim, foul them.
Yep. I mean, look at this field goal percentage. Like, it's almost even.
I didn't even realize she would pay taxes.
Yeah. Wow. That's points for IUPUI, 24 compared to NKU's 4.
Say it again.
24 bench points for the Jaguars compared to NKU's 4. Yeah. 12 personal fouls, 8 personal fouls.
I mean, NKU doesn't run very good at this, but yeah. That's sad.
I mean, this is what's getting me right here. Are the points in the paint, 32 and 28.
Huh? I was like, I'm not seeing that same much. There we go, okay.
Yeah.
That's why balls took 4 inches.
Yeah.
I thought we were up in 20 minutes, but I guess not. Yeah.
2 or 3 minutes. About 250? Yeah, is that fine? All right. Have you and Logan decided who's going to be your house guest yet? Or your guest next time?
Next week should be Quez.
More Quez? Hell yeah. That's what's up.
Sorry if it seems like I'm being selfish to you also, but like I can't just be like, oh, can you do their show too?
Yeah.
Well, I hope y'all understand that.
Oh, no. Yeah, it's fine. It's fine.
But if you all want to like reach out to people and stuff, they're super nice. Like they will definitely say yeah.
Cool.
Especially people on the like the women's basketball team.
Yeah.
They're looking for exposure. So.
All right, I'm gonna update the next team too. They're up 27-24.
Nice.
All right. Absolutely, let's get it. All right, so we're on the country tonight. Ohio State lead number 2. Ohio State leads Nebraska 33-19. Number 15, UConn over the river taking on Xavier. What a show they put on 50-13 at halftime. And number 21 Baylor, or excuse me, number 23 Oklahoma leads number 21 Baylor 35-29. And currently, right now, Iowa State up 23-16 over 7th-ranked Michigan State. Later on tonight, it's number 5 Texas taking on Houston. Coverage beginning at 8 p.m. on ESPN Plus. And we got number 14 Indiana taking on Wisconsin and Madison. Coverage starts at 8 p.m. Eastern on and college basketball events. Shots. I mean, that's going to be a key factor right there is Katie Davidson. They need to give her the ball as much as they can so the Jaguars can stay in contention in this game.
Yeah, even if she's not making shots, if she's putting shots out of him, it's going to be an opportunity for offensive rebounds and fighting with her to the basket.
I mean, it wasn't the best first half by the number two scorer in the Horizon League. I mean, but she, like late in the half, she put up 8 points. See what she can do here in the second half. Yeah, I mean. Yeah, I mean, what a half she's had. I mean, like I mentioned before, 28 of those bench points. Carter McGray was responsible for 22 points. That is impressive. And she's only a freshman.
Wow.
I was just about to bring that up. She could not be happy with that.
Number 14, Abby Walton, or one free throw.
One more. How you can rise, cut the lead down to five. Call everybody to their attention.
We have a timeout on the floor.
There's a timeout on the floor.
Gravy's creeping up overhead with DoorDash. Anywhere in the arena, pick your favorite concessions like pretzels, hot dogs, burgers, beer, and soda, and pay no additional fees. Then skip the line and pick up the drinks as soon as they're ready. Don't have the app, look for DoorDash signs around the arena, scan the QR code, and order from there.
North Station, go ahead and reach up to the sky. Yeah, it's time for Mike's Car Wash Parachute Drop, a $20 value inside of each parachute. It's an ultimate car wash if you have left any of Mike's Car Washes, multiple locations, including the ones in Erlanger and Florence. Guys, go ahead and reach up to the sky now to get your prize.
At the line of the Jaguars, number 14, Abby Alterman, 4-1 free throw.
Not a bad first half of her with 6 points, 3 out of 5, field goal. side. They're creeping back in, up into this thing. They're bringing a lot of pressure on defense. Mighty impressive by this Jaguars squad.
22 points a game off the ball.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that shot. Oh, we got a turnover. Bucket's not falling so far for the Bears.
Checking in right D.I. number 21, Antonio Walton, number 5, Jake Johnson, and number 4, Lewis Osabar. The North's number 0, Melissa Lacy.
Yep. They're doing a great job getting to the free throw line.
The Jaguars number 20, James Turner, 4-2 free throws.
Absolutely not. Like, just seeing her on the top, and she is frustrated. Much need a basket right there from her.
Seems like the last two baskets in for you is that one. Very touching.
Yep.
If they run number 33 game in Rosado, that's your second and the team's four.
Yep.
We're going to ball game in the North, number 21.
Big foul trouble right now for the North. Is their key weapon, Carter McGray, with 3.
The line for the Jaguars, number 20, Jameson Turner, 4-2 free throw.
You know they come in 9th in the conference in free throws?
Yeah.
IUPUI fellow number 21, Julia Walton, that's her second. And the team's first stop of the third quarter. We got a ball game right in the UI for Jason Jones.
4 points.
Lisa Walton.
Yep. Yeah, 11 points for the Jaguars in this half so far.
IUPUI found number 5, Jacob Johnson. That's her third. And the 2 second.
IUPUI
found number 4, Alexa Hussleton. That's her third down. She's third.
But they will call first of all for it.
Jaguars number 4, Alexa Hosovar, 4-2 free throws.
Yep. I mean, so far, that's just been the difference so far in this third quarter. I mean, I can be live there once we reach our line. I mean, so far, NJU, two for six, field goal wise, in this third quarter.
And if you look at the other side, the Jags are just 2 for 3. He's going to want to start forcing
I mean, the Jaguars on defense, they've been doing a great job pressing North Kentucky on defense. Cameron Whitaker is not happy right now. Much needed bucket right there for Northern Kentucky.
Absolutely.
IUPUI from number 5, Kevin Johnson, that's our fourth. And the team's fourth. We're getting a ball game for IUPUI number 20, Jasmine Turner. And number 21, Steve Walton, of course. Number 10, Carter McCray. Number 22, Joel Hewitt.
I mean, so now I'm thinking about it, like, Carter Lewis. Is Carter McCray in foul trouble? She's been the majority of her time on the bench. Like, I think that's been one of the problems why NKU has not been getting buckets.
Absolutely.
She's definitely the leader on this new squad.
IUPUI panel number 12, Kate Davis Jones, that's your second, and the team's fifth. We have a timeout on the floor.
Man, this game is crazy. Now it's 34-33, Green Bay.
All right, North Station, guys, get excited because it's time to play in today's Central Bay Shuffle. Obviously, we've got a big crew of contestants, and they're looking for their chance to win an NKU prize.
Two out of eight, field goals, one out of four, 3 points.
So we'll go ahead and fill you guys in.
Everybody's
in Central Bay. We're going to put a couple of trophies on the board, kind of basketball or a logo behind it. All they have to do is follow the ball and tell us where they
can started the second half.
Let's go ahead and turn to the video board to see what we have today.
Noah Reynolds has been the difference maker. He's one of the top scorers in the Verizon.
All right, contestants. I know it moves way too quickly to where everything is landed. He's going to tell me.
5 points, I think.
They say it's under the five. And congratulations. You guys are winners of today's Central Bank Shuffle Competition.
Yeah.
You're going home with a prize pack courtesy of Central Bank NKU. Thank you guys for playing.
Easy.
Appreciate you, sir.
Thanks, man.
All right, fans, go ahead and get on your feet and make some noise because our spirit squads are about to throw out t-shirts and
Central
Bank t-shirts.
All the
Levis and Crowdis Norris fans in the building are going to get any. So if you're looking to update your wardrobe, I suggest making some noise.
No. I never have any luck. You would think that reaching out would be a distraction.
Touching me.
If I was a division one, I'd be having a hard time.
Number 0, Melissa Lee. One for the Norse, number 11, Kamari Mitchell Steen, 4-2 free throws.
27 points and 7 assists in Indianapolis.
Yeah, they, yeah, would be a big factor for the Norse if she would get going here.
Mitchell Steen misses the first one. This is the second one to go. 3 point lead for the Norse.
IUPUI found number 13, Logan Lewis. That's her first.
Logan Lewis, actually, is going around, but they called him out.
I mean, so far, we haven't seen the three-point shooting from Herbert or Levis.
UPUI found the 13, Logan Lewis. That's her second.
Come here.
Lewis. At the line for the Norse, number 11, Kamari Mitchell Steen, 4-2 free throws.
Shooting 70% tonight, make it 80%.
It's
her 12th point of the contest. Yeah.
sack in the third quarter. Robertson looking for a sack, but a foul is called on the pitch.
Momentum's starting to come now for the Norse. They're trying to build up their lead.
They say that he's in his third, so I guess the numbers were off in the first half. Ball gets thrown out of the play. He's looking to scoop and score, but she can't. He's not a first place.
That is big for Northern Kentucky.
Absolutely.
It's her fourth personal.
Man, the Jags are going to the free throw.
That allows the Jaguars number 20, Tanisha Turner.
Yeah, I mean,
4-2 free throws.
McGray, she's, like I mentioned before, she's done an outstanding job in the paint, points in the paint, and now seeing her with four fouls, this is not good for Northern Kentucky. Yeah, so far the free throw line has been the key advantage for the Jaguars. I mean, 8 out of 10 compared to Northern Kentucky's 3 out of 4.
Big ball is fouled. So there's the possession. And for you, rocking their bodies in pink uniforms, and if you are rocking their bodies for Valentine's Day.
They're going to need more of Kamari Mitchell's team with Carter McGray and on the bench with foul trouble. So that's going to be a key advantage for North Carolina State in this game.
And
taking
number 33,
Gabby is on the third. All quarter, Catherine Turner attacks again, and she is up to 12 points. And she is about the red line to
try to convert the game. We have a ball game for IPU number 4, Lex Osabar. And Norse number 1, Allison Bixie. At the line for the Jaguars, number 20, Gabby Turner, for 1 free throw.
That's going to be another key advantage for Carter McGray in foul trouble.
Actually, with Carter McGray, you can focus. It's Carter McGray on the bench. You can focus on him at the end of the play. And most of them really took advantage of the bucket.
Absolutely. Got to stop on that last possession, too.
And they just like to drive to the point. They take out the ball into front folks. Carter McGray's team. He looks to spin in the paint. Oh, well, not on crawls on the back of the rim, but it falls off.
Not mad at that shot at all.
That's a rebound by Turner. The back of the rim is sprinting, but it's going away by Steen. He gets it to Kai Davis. He shifts so well.
Momentum now on the Norse's side.
Wow, on this
one. Like you said, number 21, City of Baltimore, that's her third. Freshman number 2, Jason Jones, that's her first. Checking in for IUPUI number 00, Faith Simpson, and number 5, Leah Johnson. At the line for the Norse, number 3, Kylie Davis, for 1 free throw.
Football.
Wow, that's That's crazy.
Allison Bixby from Mitchell Steam. Timeout, a 30-second timeout.
So far, there are 9 out of 12 from the line. That's going to be the key factor in this game.
Line for the Jaguars, number 12, Kate Davidson, 4-2 free throws.
This is a player like they need to rely on trying to get back into this game. Gets her own miss, did not give up on that play.
She would not be denied, and she will be rewarded for the 2 points.
On the Norse number 11, Kamari Mitchell-Steen.
I mean, she's done so far, she has done an outstanding job stepping up for Carter McRae, who is in foul trouble.
It's going to be like 13th and 14th free throw of the night. You're going to start talking their rent there.
That's
exactly what you want from these guys. You're shooting 3 or 13, so not the best shooting.
Oh, absolutely. But I mean, that's what they need to do to try to. Yeah. Exactly, just like that, right there. Just drive the pass to the hole. Try to do anything big, like a 3-point shot, because driving the lane is better confident than the game. We got an injury on the floor.
We have a ball game for IUPY.
Yep.
And number 13, Logan Lewis.
I mean, if she can't return for the game, that's going to be a key loss for this Jaguars squad. I mean, Walton, she's had a great game tonight. 14 points, 6 out of 9 field goals. Even made a 3-point shot.
Number
14 points, 4 out of 5 field goals. 6 for 7 from the free throw line. They can still get some defensive stops and still drive to the basket to get some buckets and head to the free throw line. Like that's, like I mentioned before, that's going to be their advantage if they want to get back into this game.
I think the guys were hoping for a little more kind of offensive production. They had a interview of Kevin McCoy on the bench pretty much the whole quarter, but it was just a one-point difference.
Yep.
I think they knew it for the last shot. Probably was on a turn around and drop. Jasmine Turner just cruise it, and that was not there. And there's 0.5 seconds left on the clock. It was a stream down there, and it's looking for the fourth quarter.
It's been a crazy third quarter, hasn't it, Alex?
And Norris Nation, go ahead and get excited for me to turn your attention to the court because it's time for today's Skyline Chili three-way three-shot contest. We have our two contestants out here, Micah and Isaac, and they are playing for their chance to win a whole bunch of pride and bragging rights. Guys, the way this game works, our contestants have 30 seconds to take three shots. We're looking for a layup, a free throw, and a three-pointer. Whoever can get it back first is the winner of tonight's contest. Guys, when you hear the Skyline music,
LJ Wells has 12.
Huh?
LJ Wells has 12.
He is definitely our most improved player.
Definitely. All right,
pretty good for me so far. 2 for 2, not bad.
That is, he's been turned up the heat as of late, too.
All right, let's go into the three-pointer. And here it is. Congratulations, Isaac. You're the winner of today's Skyline Chili three-way three-shot contest. Thank you, both of you, for heading out.
That was like, well, like he was on the bench all season last year, I think.
All right, fans, go ahead and turn to the video board because it's time for tonight's Delta Dental Smile Cam. Delta Dental of Kentucky, serving over 700,000 smiles across the Commonwealth. And tonight, we want to go ahead and see yours. Let me see those smiles. I mean, just IUPUI taking advantage of the free throw line, but NKU, they were able to find some momentum on offense without Carter McRae. With 17 points, she is
turned up the heat so far.
Absolutely. Blevins gets a little turnaround in the paint today. The first shot of the third quarter.
I mean, the key factor for Carter McRae is stay out of foul trouble, because we're going to need her at the end of the fourth, and IUPUI, they can easily come back from 10 points. You just never know.
Saw on that defensive possession right there. She's making sure she has her hand spread up, so there is no chance of a foul call getting on her.
Yeah.
There's 1 second on the shot clock, but it looks like they just reset it. Assuming everybody got to the bench, I presume to look at.
I see why taking a foul says to the bench. At the line, the most number 21, Mixie Levins, 4-2-3 Bros.
That's a technical foul.
Wow.
Mixie Levins at the line now. Can you get a spot on the game?
I mean, I didn't see what the technical foul was about. I mean, if you're IUPUI, this is not looking good. Yep.
3 points are all right now.
Yep, absolutely. I mean, she's been an elite shooter since her time at Notre Dame Academy.
Absolutely.
Absolutely crazy.
Lisa Turner.
She's got definitely got a bright future.
Number 13, Logan Lewis, 4-2 free throws.
I mean, like I mentioned before, they're going to have to nail these free throws. She's with Carter McRae and foul trouble. She's another key player that has done an outstanding job.
This is by Jason Jones.
That's the Jaguars' first 3-point shot made in the second half.
Back and forth for the quarter for sure.
Number 21, Leah Walton.
with 7 minutes to go. They can still get back into it. This game is far from over, but that is not looking good right there. They turned it right back over to Mary Mitchell's team. Yeah, like they need to stop right here. Yep, doing what she does best is getting points in the paint. Not worth to risk anything.
Absolutely. We're going to go all down low. We're going to double team this time. The coaching.
Kylie Davis, the Kamari Mitchell's team.
And Cameron Wells has to come
out. And we have a second on the floor.
The shot clock is dwindling down, so we need to get a second on the floor.
I used to dance this song on Just Dance, I believe. I mean, just looking at these stats right here, like everybody showed up to play on both sides, IUPUI and Western Kentucky.
All right, Norris Nation, we had all of the rock and roll vibes up with this next activity. You guys go ahead and pull out your air guitars and start shredding for today's air guitar game.
Thank you. I mean, just like Turner at the free throw line, like, that's how you pull your eyes come out. They go up to that variety of their players. Scoring the Verizon League, she's definitely had a much better second half with 18 points.
Turner got 18 points after shooting 9 of 11 from the free throw line.
Yep.
And now, MVP looks like that. Just about 4 minutes left to go here in the game. They're looking like they're in good shape.
Yeah, 23 points from Kamari Mitchell-Steen.
That one goes off the front end. Jasmine Turner with the rebound. He's got to pick it off for three. Davidson, that one's not good. Rebound by Turner. That's another
one. Jasmine Turner.
And she has a block by Turner. Gets the ball back there, kicks it out. 4-3 from Davis. No good. Rebounded.
Man, you gotta make those. That should have been a bucket right there.
I found the 14
Jaguars number 22.
Yeah, I would say so.
And Walter Bennett.
I mean, just to recap of this game, Alex, like, it's been a really good game between these two teams. I mean, Carter McRae with 24, just being one of the best freshmen in the Horizon League. Carter McRae's team with 23, doing an outstanding job. Macy Blevins, three-point shooting, showed up as she was 2 out of 3 with 16 points. And well, Herbert was perfect for him 3 tonight, but she went 3 for 3.
Jasmine Turner gets another bucket to go.
Yeah, absolutely crazy. Points in the paint has been like the key factor in this game.
Important to her to see him go in after he's been sitting so long and not being able to get any help, and most of the club teams coming.
Absolutely.
Second one is off the back iron, and now you can get out of rebound and make the pick. Jesse Jones leading the offense. This is the Davidson. He flicked it out to Hitchiger, and it's flipped by Mrs. Green, but how do you all keep it up? And you gotta feel like NKU feels good today. Definitely on pace to take 95 on APUI, like APUI did in the matchup last
year. Absolutely. Good revenge from what happened in Indianapolis in late January.
And the team, looking at both up and miss by APUI. And again, 2 of 5. And Jackson Bowles called for a cut. After 2 slams of ball down.
Yeah, she was not happy with that call at all.
That's her fifth. It
looks like she will foul out.
You like technical foul, number 20, Jasmine Turner.
And that's her question from Mitchell Steen. Getting picking up so many fouls and fouls now. It's a combination of those things.
Yeah. Like, Turner, though, she's had a great game, like putting up 22 points. She's 10 out of 11 free throw line, 6 out of 7 field goals. Like, she really showed up tonight. And I can see the frustration there. Like, she played her heart out, but unfortunately, it's just not enough for the Jaguars.
Yeah, she was a good part of this offense tonight. And you know, she was going to be out there for the next game. Yeah, I'm getting back.
The
newest
number 11,
Warren Mitchell Steen, 4 to 3 votes. Second goal. Mitchell Steen shooting her 18th and 19th free throw of the night. And Jackson both the goals.
And the newest number 21, Macy Lennox, 4 to 3 votes.
100 games.
Like, they struggled from the beginning, just like you mentioned, Alex, but I just feel like later in the season, especially in conference play, they can try to figure out who they are as a team, and if they just put the pieces together, like, they're a dangerous squad. Even the record doesn't show, they could be contenders in the Indianapolis and Horizon League tournament.
Charlie Davis gets that one today, Central U 97-78. And a big part of their turnaround, honestly, happened after Charlie UI game the last time.
Yeah.
Since then,
time to take the substitution time of the
absolutely.
And the substitution timeout just took place to get a couple of the people who don't usually get playing time in here right now. Coach Hodgson, Chris Lacey,
Trevor Hunter right here.
And Milano, Davis is running up and running up, but he's playing over there. We're down to 90 seconds here.
I think you found the number zero, Melissa Lacey. That's her second, and the team's fourth.
I
mean, that Wright State game when they travel up to Dayton, like, I'm looking forward to seeing that one because Wright State, they've been an elite defense all year. Top five in offense in the Horizon League.
Come on,
let's get some more. This is
I'm not sure.